Hello, I'm Scott Brown with Green Wind and other home energies. Well, remember this. This is the hub spindle and bearing setup, plus the redneck grease cap, of course. We'll lay this down on its side. We have to get into some metal work before we can assemble everything that we've done so far. You see here, I've traced out the shape that I got off this thing. I was looking for some quarter-inch flat bar. I didn't want to use some bed iron, because what's with the head is some 3/8 inch. That's a little bit thick. I've already ground one of these, and this fits pretty well right there. It's going to go right up against the square of the back of this. Usually you can sit there and you can put all three of these at 120 degrees from each other, so you got a perfect Y or star. These don't touch for the diameter that I have to weld it to. I could weld a couple pieces. I could have welded a couple pieces from here to the next piece and all the way around, left the hole. But I've got a lip here to weld to anyway. I'll just go ahead and line them up. Got my protractor set up over here at 120 degrees. So anyway, for the time being, I guess just a little bit of grinding and setting all this up. That'll take care of this part of the metal work, and then we'll get to welding. One other thing, right here, you don't want to use a vise, which this one probably wouldn't hold it right. I've got a couple vises, but I don't want to mount the big one up here. You can take these vise C-clamps that they use for welding and metal stud framing and other things, and clamp it to the edge of your desk. That way you can grind right there and get some pressure and grind real nice. When I get this shape, this ought to be real nice and easy to weld. Okay, well there's number two. See, that fits real nice. Anyway, I might show you the next one being ground.
Okay, here's the third one. I don't recommend you do it this way, but I'm trying to save a little time. First of all, I cut into it. And then we switch to the grinder and we should finish it off pretty quick.
Alrighty, see how that matches up. Pretty close. I think I need to knock the sides a little bit.
Almost perfect. Let's see, are we square on the tips? Eh, we'll take this side off. Alright, now that we're done, that'll help it weld a lot easier. Nice clean surface, got to do it to the other ones too. When you've got a nice clean metal, that helps it weld real good. I got to do the same thing on the other piece.
All right, now we got to grind off a little of this and get this all set up so it'll weld nice and easy. Do these edges. Taking the high spots off the old weld, but cleaning all this metal helps you to weld. Trying to weld over paint, you usually make a pretty decent weld or a very bad weld. So especially if you're a first time welder, you really want to get this off and you're going to get what they call booger weld. And there we are. The next thing is to grind down into these a little bit and make a little valley where you can sink your weld into. I'm going to have to do this on both sides because this weld here is beveled out a little bit. Got a lot of wind out here tonight. Now flip it over and do the same thing on the other side. All right, it's flipped over. That's pretty good. I'll do the other two off camera. You see, I welded down the side and I welded over here. These are not the prettiest welds. As a matter of fact, they're a lot better than the welds I was doing last night when I was trying to finish this up. There's a box of welding rods the right size for this welder. It's only a 70 amp. Last night I was using one about this thick. This is 1/8 inch. This is 3/32. Much better for this welder. The other thing, remember I said I wanted to use 1/4 inch. Well, this 3/8 inch sure does absorb a lot of the heat. So I kind of had to weld slow and let this thing absorb some heat. Then I could actually get some more weld into it. Well, anyway, I've got to weld around here. This is not going to be the structural support, but it's only going to be holding the stator in place. And I've got welds all the way out to here, all the way out over here, and across on the bottom. I think I can get the mirror to show that. Yeah, well, it doesn't show it very well. But, there we are. Now I can get a picture of it. There's a weld on the bottom of that one. I haven't welded this one over here on the bottom. You can see it's... I can get the light to move at the same time. There we go. I haven't welded under there. I'm fixing to weld under that. But anyway, I need to show you how to get your angles. This one here, you can see is square. It's 90 degrees coming out from this flat surface. Well, we have a protractor here. I hope it focuses good enough where I can see. I'll move it a little bit. There we are. It shows 120 degrees, and that means when I put this right against the edge here and get out of my own light, there we are, this comes out, and there's my 120 degrees or 60 degrees from this 90, and I've got that set in good. What I did to do this, and I'm sorry I didn't do this on camera with you, is I went and clamped it with this, like this, and then tapped it with a hammer until I got it adjusted. I tapped the bottom over, and then I tapped the end and tapped everything until I got it, and then hammered it in on the end several times until I got it to line up, and then I started my welds. I'm about ready to weld the other side, and then I'm going to put the third one on. I'm going up to Boomer's. He's got a bigger welder, something that I can weld with a lot easier, and we'll get the rest of these welds up. Oh, what's my welder look like? Well, there's my fan, and there's the welder. Fan bigger than a welder, I think. Many good thanks to you and yours. Okay, I wanted to show you. I'm going to turn this to exactly 120 degrees. It wouldn't be fair for me to set up one more without you showing. Now, you see here, with this touching here, I've got a gap over here. So I'm going to tap this with a hammer. Bottom over, tap it up, just to show you what I was talking about. A little closer. Okay, good. Tap the bottom over, tap the top over, tap it back up in. And that right there, pretty much exact. I think I need to tap it out just a touch. How hard you hit it, I guess. And that right there is perfect. I'm going to go to welding. I'm not going to weld on camera. It's the only good camera I got that I don't have to do what I did at the beginning of this video and videotape it off the screen so I can edit it. Anyway, I thank you very much for watching. I'm Scott Brown with Green Wind and Other Home Energies. I'll show you one more shot of everything welded up when I'm done. And then I got to pack up. You see, I welded all the way from here, over to here, back down around the edge. The same thing over here on this one. I didn't quite get under all from here to this edge, but I'm not really worried about that. But these are all stout. I'll give you the test on it. You can't knock the welds off. They're solid. Don't be afraid to hit it with a hammer. Don't be afraid to hit it. I mean, don't be afraid to smack it. I'd rather find out now and find out later on. Good solid welds. Doesn't look all that pretty. They ain't wonderful. Anyway, you gotta hit them anyway. Get the slag off them. See what they look like. See how they start to shine. You get that slag off them. That's actually the flux that's on the outside of the rods. All right, there we go. We got 120 degrees, 120 degrees, 120 degrees for a total of 360 degrees. It's all solid and welded, and we're ready to put the stator up against her and find out exactly where we're going to drill our holes. The excess I'll probably cut off and use for some stock for setting the tail fin off the right angle. I believe I'm going to put that at about 22 and a half degrees, somewhere around there. This concludes the first part of the Metalworks, part 21. Dual magnet rotor axial flux wind turbine. I'm Scott Brown with Green Wind and Other Home Energies. Many good things to you and yours.